So kuna watu wana suggest that itakuwa a female deputy president. So what's the probability of that happening? Kenya getting its first female deputy president?
Who? Can you put a name to that?
Waiguru.
How come every time there's like a huge job anywhere, people tout Waiguru for the job? Like kunaskinga this place ayuko tekana ni Waiguru. Council of Governors tekana ni Waiguru. What's the Waiguru thing?
But of course, Michael, unakuwaga ni comedian, eh?
Yeah, stand-up comic, mazi.
Yeah, so unakuwaga na akina nani? Akina Kisiangani, ama?
Najua hiyo mbugi yote. Some of them have been here. Tunafanyanga the same scene.
Okay.
Mm.
Yeah, okay.
Mm. Yeah, yeah. Mina enjoy stand-up a lot, mazi. Like, ndiyata nikuwa niwambia like a few seconds ago. Mina, I feel like some things are just a calling, like true activism.
Yeah.
You can tell when you see a true activist. You need a genuine calling. Mm. Sometimes my material in as a border on like the political thing because you're in Kenya.
Yeah, it's everywhere.
You cannot miss it.
Unajua? Politics is everywhere.
Yeah, but I just know I'm a comedian first. Unajua? And I think like comedy is important, maze your speech to you could express to ni kitu fiti sana.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, comedy inakuwaga. Like, mimi waga, like, even at kuna shot nafanyaga, for the weekend update. So it's me, Rapture, Ian, na saizi tukona Zach. And the weekend update is literally inspired na the weekend update ya SNL, Saturday Night Live, US. The fact that they talk about news and whatever has happened, that's the same thing that we do. So, mina jua like the power of comedy. Alafu kwa sema, kuna event mna organize?
Yeah, so, okay, here's the thing. I'm putting on my own. I'm curating my stand-up comedy open mic.
Okay.
In the CBD.
Yeah.
Itakuwa Taos in Koinange Street. Now everyone has a genuine excuse to hang around there on a Friday night. So the open mic is in Koinange Street. There's this nice restaurant up in itwa Pete's. They have a rooftop spot. Neck up the open mic. I feel like guys are starting to gravitate towards what we are doing. We've been underground for a while. I started like this is like my third year doing stand-up comedy.
Yes.
Tumekuwa tu tukidu clips, tunazifanya hizo clubs huko. There's one in Kilimani, there's another one in Lavi. But I've always felt like we need to have at least one in the CBD. Unajua? So for the guys who are in the CBD una frequent Tao, on Fridays we have Freaky Friday pale Pete's. Yeah, it starts this Friday actually, in the 11th of October. Yeah, you have to book. So attendance is strictly by booking. The thing about comedy pieces in Guinea, you have to have a deliberate effort to curate kidogo.
Okay.
Yeah, because otherwise if you get like idlers or guys who just want to drink and rave, it'll mess up your atmosphere, the guys who are there for comedy. Yeah, so book, you say you're coming to takwekea spot. Come check, you enjoy.
So, una book, but it's free entrance. Ama?
It's free entrance, yeah. But okay, you have to spend something on your table.
Yes, yes, of
course. So that the establishment can see it. I'm going to buy V2. But it's free. It's an open mic. It's not a paid show.
And it's on a Friday?
Yes, every Friday. I think I call it Freaky Friday because it's the fastest name I could come up with. So maybe it's not
too Freak Offs Friday.
Freak Offs, mazi sina baby oil, ndugu yangu. Baby oil, ndakuna.
Yeah, say Joe, damn. Diddy. Every done. Time I try to
he's done, Maze.
To forget Diddy, it ends up he come up. Alafu, wacha tubongejia US politics kidogo. Alafu sasa tuta come back to the Kenyan scene, eh? So anaitwa Elon Musk alikuwa anasema that if America does not vote for Trump, America will be in trouble. What do you think?
Now here's what I think. If you me from like my outsiders nini opinion nikiangalia to your climate your political nini yao, Trump is really the soul of the country. You can tell most Americans when identify na Trump they're losing their heart and soul of the country. There's too much immigration.
Yeah,
what's up atakwenda? Okay, there's nothing wrong with immigration. Apparently the issue is illegal immigration. Now the other side, the Democrats, they foster this climate of illegal immigration to get voters. A lot of their voters are like undocumented immigrants, nini. So you can tell, like, side ya kina Kamala, as in my puppets for big company, the big corporations, the money people. But Trump, kuna venya ame identify na the traditional American, yani the truckers, just the regular, all white, ila white picket fence American, who ni Trump.
Okay, because it's very interesting, vilo mebonga jwe, video mesema all white. Because Trump, the typical American, I'd say the racist American, the white American who's afraid that they are losing their country. Because mm-hmm. shida states ni inasemekana saizi, I think by the 2050, Latinos atakuwa the majority, yes? So that's scary. And mm. it's scary because America is one of those societies that race is a very important issue. Very. So like mm-hmm. other countries, as much as they are white countries, race is never not tricky. Like America, if you're black, you're African-American. Pogba is French. He's not black French. He's not African French.
Mm-hmm.
He's French.
Mm-hmm.
Na cheki. Mm-hmm. So America iko na your aspect. History ya immigration. This is how I look at it. Mm-hmm. I look at America, yes?
Mm.
And I look at immigration this way. Texas is a Republican state, yes?
Yes.
California is Democrat.
Mm.
So our illegal immigrants, unless they are going to the swing states, what are they affecting? Understand? Because that's why muitaga American, mumu quote nani? I quote John Stewart on this. You say American politics ni tribal. And by tribal, anamaanisha, people will always vote specific patterns, yes?
Mm-hmm.
If you're a Republican, uta vote Republican like 9 times out of 10.
Mm-hmm.
So with that in mind,
mm.
kitu ina happen in America ni ukona nini? Kitu ina happen in America ni kuna vile California wana vote blue nini wana, so the swing states,
yeah,
that's where if the immigrants are going to the swing states, then immigration is being used to swing the vote. But as long as it's electoral college and it's not a popular
mm-hmm.
vote,
mm-hmm.
how does immigration come in?
But you know, even just okay, unaweza kuona point, but just even immigration as an issue, ukiangalia tu on a personal level, you this na kumbuka it's illegal immigrants.
Yes.
So wana come in, unapata like the local government, governor hapo, anawapatia social amenities. Go to this hotel, go to the... So some of the Americans are like, wait a minute, we are poor.
That's some racist shit. It really works that way. Because even right now, kuna black on black racism, yes?
Mm-hmm.
And I will articulate your point, but kuna ama blacks wanajita FBS, Foundational Black Americans.
Mm-hmm.
And they say the same thing about Africans, that Africans tukienda huko, tunapatiwa free money, tunapatiwa, tunanuliwa mahao, tunanuliwa. I met a lot of Kenyans in the US. I doubt if they got anything for free. A lot of them are working their asses off.
Yeah.
Are there a few maybe favors they may do for immigrants? Maybe, but a lot of, you have to see that also my immigrants working in the States, kuna wale wengi, they see opportunities where Native Americans don't see. By Native, I don't mean, okay.
That's true. Let me
say, Americans don't see. Because Native, of course, unamaanisha Indians, Red Indians, who are not Indians in any way. Wachiki hapo najipoteza. But wakienda, wanawachiki give it to Americans don't see. Because you've come from extreme poverty.
It makes sense, yeah.
You're going to see opportunities where they are not. But according to una feel like immigrants,
so, okay, so unasema, hiyo ni like propaganda inakuwa peddle.
Propaganda, according to mimi. But okay, your state unzatuambia, kama maybe you're my immigrants and you're getting favors because you're immigrants, let us know.
Kwa sababu even like the numbers ya illegal immigration, maze ni crazy. It even from like, ata unaweza angalia uone, damn, maze.
Any numbers gani mwana? Wacha ni Google.
Ebu Google tu yeah, cheki. America. Na unangatuma right-wing publications pale YouTube. Bado unasema numbers zina.
Immigrants.
Shoot. And then these guys, you have to create an environment where there's no disease, there's no need. So you have to give them some social amenities and it's paid for by the American taxpayer.
Mm.
Na yon do the root of the issue.
Because the U.S. foreign-born population reached a record of 47.8 million in 2023. 47.8, this is from around 350 million. That's 50 divided by, that's around 14%, yes?
Mm.
Okay, an increase of 1.6 million from the previous year. The largest annual increase in more than 20 years since 2000. Okay. In 1970, the number of immigrants living in the U.S. Was about a fifth of what it is today.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, of course, the numbers zimekuwa zikiincrease.
Wild.
Yes. So, I understand why wasi wanakata. But most of the people wali wanakata mostly because of the color. Yangozi. I don't think wakizusha jua illegal immigration wanajali jua the British and the Norwegians going there. Wanawori moja.
The Hispanics and the blacks.
Na Hispanics, alafu apart from Hispanics, Waarabu. Ya Waarabu mu understand because they want to come, na they maintain all their cultures, which is wrong. like hakuna vile uta expect kutembea Texas kwa umejifunika. Just don't do it.
Assimilate your culture.
I know it's your culture, but choose. Either nataka kukaa states ama nataka kukaa nje. Usiende juu huko umejifunika sura hivi. Na wewe mwenyewe kwa umeenda kumari states, usi expect demi yako atembee hivi. Mtakuwa you'll be violently attacked. Unajua hivyo? Kwa sababu ni walami, they feel like they're losing their country. Alafu wamekuja na culture nyingine, it makes sense. Wewe ushaangalia sura ya demu ka state. Kwani huko na usupu gani ila zaidi? Ukienda huko, drop your cultures.
Yeah.
You have to lose some. Na Waarabu watakaagi kuchange kitu yote. Wanaendaga place jo wame maintain na ile ni wanataka kuitreat kama ni Riyadh. Yeah, wanatolewa Riyadh.
But part of you part of you pendangi that really conservative aspect of Islam. Yani madem tu yani relax.
Yes. Acha demo onekane.
Like
sura at all animals. There are other animals that do. Yeah. I never separate ourselves from animals, yes? Alafu ia nusipoteza your train of thought.
Yeah.
Alafu the guy who actually came up with the theory of evolution was a Muslim. That's one thing watu wajua.
Evolution.
The guy who came up with the theory of evolution ilikuwa a Muslim scholar.
Mm.
Back in the days, Baghdad used to be a center place for intellectuals.
Yeah.
Umsali came up with a theory of evolution in the 1200s. Alikuwa nasema, alafu ya lipatia a very simple explanation. All animals have an animal that looks like them. Ajivo. Endo angalie, ngombe iko na buffalo. Apart from buffalo, kuna ngombe waga wild ile waga na tail short. Ajivo. Kichwa kama ngombe, everything. Afu kuna wildebeest.
Ile the American one.
Yes. Afu kuna wildebeest. So all animals have relatives and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, toki angalia dogs, hyenas, jackal, foxes.
Alafu angalia images za Somalia in the 1970s. Mademo alikuwa anatembea na short skirts and everything.
I just especially kuna ile like there's a line that like this ultra feminists have crossed. So you meet a really staunch feminist who's over that line. And then you know, contrast na like a very quiet Muslim girl, you're like this could be the alternative.
Do you also want such a nini? Because Mr. Ki wife ani respect cuz na deki. Nataka wife ani respect you ani respect. I need more than that.
Yeah.
I don't want you to be that submissive. I want you to be wild. Nataka ile time tunafanya ngono, tunafanya ngono ni kama hatuko tu Ruto ongeza ushuru. Yaani kama atuwezi sema Ruto ongeza ushuru. We are not doing it right.
Yeah.
I take it. So,
yeah, of course na kwa facetious nikisema of course they suppress their women too hard.
But Jakarta do that even in Kenya. Do that everywhere, but when you go to America, you have to change.
Yeah,
you have to know you're not welcome.
Simulate.
Yes.
Like would you go to states alafu hapo nje weke flag ya Kenya? Like vile mbona na wakiweka flag zao.
Nikiweka flag ya Kenya nitaweka ya states pia.
Yeah.
Nitamake sure nimeweka zote mbili.
Yeah.
Acheki. Like I'll represent for Kenya and also represent for what America has done for me. Nikuwa ina tagro nikuwa vidogo vijiji. But
yeah, because nilikuwa nasema hivyo.
Matumia Starlink. I think I saw a video of you on
Bob. Yeah. Niko na Starlink, but nilipatia na voucher. Me, I'm still using Safaricom, not because I love Safaricom, but because of content creation, Safaricom works better.
So Elon, your guy, mazea kujia kwenye Trump mbaya sana.
Yeah, but, yes, which I understand. Najua kuna hiyo story ya race and what. Bila nasema, white people feel like they're losing America.
Because it's the same case wa nani, chenye nani, alipeleka uhuni yake huko. Dida.
So na check your story. I think the first thing unafaa ku understand if you're going to a foreign country, yes, and I feel like this is something that has happened with Sisi wale tuko like very native Kenyans and very whatever, like Wasapere, Wajaka, you understand Sisi ni wase tukiendaga somewhere, if you're a visitor you behave the way the owner of the house wants you to behave, you understand. So mjaka amezaliwa ujakani 100%. Akishia Israel, nasikia hapa Israel bila kutahiri utarudishwa kwenu. Atatahiri without asking questions.
Really?
Yes.
I feel like they would say maybe the opposite. Like us guys with strong culture will try to hold on to our culture.
We change. That's why ukishia gama like majuzi nikiwa states nilimiti game toy flani anaitwa Kimathi. And Kimathi is so American that you know, like budake na madhake waliza. Hata madhake akibonga kilami utanotice. Kuna accent ya states but kuna ile accent ya kisapiri hapo ndani. So you know the way it mixes. Eh? But Kimathi mwenyewe is so American that you just see an American. Achiki. So there is that element. But other cultures, au wagana yu element, you want to keep some of your culture. Kuna kugatana, kuna time UK walianza ku crack down on female genital mutilation. Like when it happened, kuna pata like Somali wanaitwa nini refugees wameenda huko, mtu yanatolewa Brito analetwa Africa kufanywa FGM. Like at what point do you know that these are medieval practices? Unacheki, and no one is attacking your culture, but if you want to do the medieval practices in Kenya, do them. If you want to do them in Somalia, do them. Do not do them huko.
And cross the border.
Wacheki, so you know kitu nasema, you have to drop a few of your things. These things are not, haziko, they are not, what is it called? They are not cast in stone.
Yeah.
These are, there's a reason they happened during those times. And there's a reason why it doesn't happen right now. So you always have to be, if you're invited to someone's house, behave the way the person wants. If not,
I feel like those guys who mentioned, like the ISO communities, let's say they're adaptable. They can adapt to check. Because that's how you mentioned the Luo specifically. Man, Luos have a rich culture that they love. Like, nilikuwa nasoma book ya Miguno. She has some book table by there.
And peeling the mask.
Checky, Miguno. Peeling the mask. He's very interesting. When I say he can write like you cannot imagine. So, kwa book yake, alikuwa describe vile. He went to Canada, he studied there, nini. So, he has 5 children. All of these children, none of them, to my knowledge, nikisoma kwa book, they have like westernized names. The first one, Nyanyango, Akinyi, Achieng, Biko, and I think Sure. So, una bado the Luo in him.
Yes, name, maintain, Obama, maintain. Maintain, but Obama has how many daughters? Has 2 daughters. Does not have a son. In Luo culture, sons were put above daughters. In Kikuyu culture, they treat their daughters with respect. The daughters can inherit and blah, blah, blah. You understand?
I see.
So you have to be malleable.
Yeah.
But if you're in Kenya, you don't have to be malleable. You see, if you're in Kenya, maintain all the cultures you want to maintain. But nasema, ukienda kwa nyumba ya mtu. Like ukienda, one day, ushaenda ga Europe. Ian, ukienda Europe. Ama, mi place najua kabisa, ni places mbili. Amsterdam, and pia nishaona US, yes? During summer, people are actually literally naked. Yes?
Damn.
You can't be disgusted by that.
No, tulishiaga, there's no chance.
Ndapatia an example lingine. Tuliendaga, tukiwa Texas, tulishia Wendy's. I've never forgotten this. So, ilikuwa mimi, Moranga, na besti yake flani, mkisi. Mkisi flani ametoka. I think ametoka Ocha. Alafu, but ameishi states for some time. But he's not changed his mind. Because you can also be there and not change your mindset. So, there was this gay dude. Ule alikuwa hapo, anatuserve. And I could see the disgust in him. And I'm there looking at him like, Buddha, umekuja kwa wenyewe. Kikuja kwa wenyewe, you don't have that privilege. Hauna privilege ya kuwa disgusted. Hata upate dudes, mbili ziko pale, ziko, rudi kwenyu, Buddha.
It's not your place, man.
Una understand?
Yeah.
Ukiwa kwa wenyewe, hauna your freedom. Awezi kama hapa, iko nene, alafu umekaa uko like, Buddha Joseph Jafraia vile umekanyaga hiyo kiti. Ndio Buddha wewe jitom.
Kwambie hii mic, Joe, hii mic hata Joe ni pick fit.
So that's what nasema, like ukienda kwa wenyewe.
Hata I think that's what happening. That's what's happening with at Springfield. The air in the dogs.
Yes.
In the cats.
Kusuna sayo adults.
Kusuna say.
They're not becoming part of it.
Yeah, wameenda wamepeleka. Na nini, it's getting even in the way of Malema blacks when you're cool, it's not even about nani anymore. Mecheki wakidu vlogs wakisema like, oh, I don't know what. Zile raya za nini za hate. Za hate, yeah.
Una grab duck kutoka kwa. Kutoka kwa pond.
Kwa fountain.
Yeah,
ati wanenda kwa nini, ati when they are alive. Of course, wana exaggerate. But I think you now emphasize the point that, you know, whatever your cultures are not welcome here.
Yeah.
Like when you come here, you're supposed to conform. And you know, nanga kwa movies wakiuliza, hey, you're a long way from home. You know, where you going?
Yeah.
You know, sana sana nasikianga wakiuliza hivyo. Panisha, you look lost around here. Like, what's your motive?
And tunasema ukonform zile, kama dressing, vituka, na kudress imanisha tu vai miniskirt. You can wear your long stuff, eh? But don't do anything that makes you really stand out. Alafu, on top of that, ukisha conform na suweza dressing. Hakuna mtu anakuambia uende dinyo rasa. Kuliko na plan kudinyo rasa. Lakini pia, as a foreigner, it's not within your right kuenda kukriticize wasona dinyo rasa kwa hizo inchi. Because that's there. That's no, part of their society.
It's also the same way. Like a perfect example ni mademu wa Nairobi. Wakiwa kwa beach, they can be naked.
Yeah.
But wakitambia hizi mita, za course, they cover up kuchu. But it's because they know that's like, of course, Islam is big huko. and umeenda huko, you just stand out, you just you don't know what you're going to attract. Mm-hmm. If it's ridicule or sijui nini ama ile shame.
Mm-hmm.
Like yewe funiki as you know.
Mm-hmm.
So nimetembea nao na nanga.
Mm-hmm.
Tukienda places zingine they cover up.
Yes. It's the same thing like nguo naweza vaa westi hawezi vaa isili. Makes sense. Unajua hivyo?
Mm-hmm.
Like dame anaenda na mini skirt fulani westi and it's okay because first of all the people are rich. That means they are less angry. Alafu, but the same scar.
That means they are less angry.
Yes. Poverty ufanya
na hasira. That's funny.
Yeah, unazenda shop flan, mall flan, yeah. Usiuziwe.
But sasa, the same scar, ukienda nayo wakulima market, expect harassment. Ukienda nayo isili, expect sneers. And these sneers, they'll be out of you are disrespecting the people there. Unacheki? Because in this place, we are conservative. This is how we dress. You can't show up there with. So, Musa maga like adapt hizi places zote. But now, if ukingia tu kwa ile tube, kukwa ndege, buda unenda a foreign country. Ukipataka hiyo inchi, ni kama kuenda India kukanyaga mavi alafu wanze kuteta. Buda ulikuwa na expect ni. The revolution is still acting. Na pia, awezi enda kukula nyama India.
Yeah.
Unaunderstand? Kini hizi vitu zote?
Hizo societal norms ni interesting sana. Place ka Japan, noja Japan wanangana ile like proper culture, yani wako na good art, nini, wanapenda uniformity. So ndio na Japan, society ita look down on you kwa umenona. You cannot just be fat in their society.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm.
Unajua, so unenda huko mazi una slim. Otherwise, ukiwa fat, mazi watu wana kuangalia. Kwa sababu uwezi stand out in Japanese culture, ukai like an anomaly.
Yeah, una need kuwa part.
No, actually, ukita kukonda, just visit a normal Japanese home.
Mm.
And I feel you pick a time ya kushawa.
Yeah, ushasikia hiyo? Hii tulichanuliwaga na Evans, Evans Musoka.
Uh-huh.
Unamjua?
The comedian. He's a comedian in Japan. Kenyan comedian.
Yes, he's best. Mwambia yo story, Japan.
Anakuanga Japan. So alisema, Japan, cause of time, you know. They shower together.
Familial time. Showers.
Familial.
Mm.
As in, wewe, budako.
Cheki, unajua nakedness vile inaweza kuwa offensive. What if I go on a shower?
What if I put the whole list?
Budako, your mom, your sister.
Brother.
Mnasuguana mgo.
Mm. Okay, sijui kama mnasuguana, but...
Is there a chance aliembelishe story ya kachocha kidogo?
You can all... Zizi. Wajua the funny thing about life.
No.
Kuna kukana hizi. Wahenga. Mu dismiss wahenga. Because they lived in their own time. But there are a few things they got right. Eh? Kutembea kwingi kuwa na mengi.
For sure.
There's a lot of stuff that we don't, it's not normal to us, but it's very normal in other societies. The same way, story of transgenderism, place kama Bangkok, Thailand, it's very normal.
Oh, the and, boy girls.
Yes, and you're not looked down upon. Mm. I think there's another culture, I don't know if it's Sumerians, ama kitu kama yu, there's another culture, ama Suriname, where in their culture, if a family gets one gender, they nominate one kid to act like a different gender.
Jeez.
So, if you're in a family of girls, peke yake wanza chagua moja, wanza kumambia we vaa matrao, vaa nini, kuwa boy wa family. Mpata maboy wote, wanachagua moja jo na kuwa kamboche jo. Kwa sasa huko, your family pia inakuwaga, like the girl is the one who's supposed to cook and do all that. So, they do that. So, there are these different societies. But now, the most interesting thing pia nilisikia, in South Africa, they call kuna hiyo like the reason why like gay people in South Africa wako more accepted than every other part of Africa ni huko they talk about energy na wanasema kuna watu wako na hiyo feminine energy like men who have feminine energy and they have men who have masculine energy. Hachiki kutembea kwingi kuona mengi, but kile tunasema ni as long as umeenda hizi society, one of the reasons why immigrants wanatandikwa US hivi because they go there and they want to act like they're back home.
Yeah.
That can't happen. Unacheki, ukienda huko, Buddha adjust kitu.
Assimilate.
Na kama uwezi adjust, Buddha airport iko pale, rudi. Si tulienda na tukarudi hapa, kwa zaatu uwezi adjust jo.
Niko.
Unacheki.
Na uwezi adjust your life.
Si, neza adjust, but nasema tu, like, unirudi.
Approach. Si ati niko Brooklyn, lafu naambia niggas. You need to work, man.
Yeah.
Ha, umewaingia mbaya hii. Unajama niggas wa wakingi. Wana chill on the block.
You need to work.
Yeah, au kuna bitu wawezi. Wawezi enda pale, alafu. Umeenda
New York
kuanza kupika githeri unataka kuzia ase. Alafu isiponunuliwa ati mnadharau chakula yangu. No one needs that shit.
Because so, nakumbuka hata na there was some certain YouTuber of which maybe I don't know how you're going to take this. Mimi niliona ni kama it wasn't right to the way he reacted. Alena alikula nini? Alikula smocha. Unajua smocha? Like chapati, kachumbari, alafu smoky. Alafu ana nini? Hiyo ndio naitwa smocha, smoky chapati. So squeezy ni common sana.
Yes.
Hata ukitembea hapo hivi just see. So of course aliambiwa like okay, things alikuwa anafuata kwa comments, things you need to try. Akiwa Kenya. Akumbuka na alibite smocha and they were like, "Hey, what the fuck is this?"
Smocha is like an acquired taste. Au alimrusha depend kwanza. Wangempeleka kwanza.
I also feel like, you know, hii ni kitu alikuwa ameambiwa try because people love it na nini. But ile disgust alikuwa nayo. Unajua?
Ilikuwa
friend. I just feel.
So, can't you get?
No maju.
Na try hapa Kenya?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So me, I just felt like...
We also get disgusted na cheese yao, na vitukai. I think we only overthink. Fuck it.
It offended Ian. When is pocha for? When was he?
Maybe I'll try to be sensitive. Yeah. Maybe ni mimi. Maybe I'll try to be sensitive.
Mimi
nitauma, alafu. Off camera, nitasema fuck that shit. You get it?
Yeah. Because the way they eat that cheese shit, like cheese huko ni.
Fuck that. Before I look on, I'm about even
cold cheese.
Cold food. Eh?
Yeah, like this cold cheese. Even apart from that, like, and.
Na uli seme hapa.
This is something that.
Uli seme hapa. Uku seme hapa.
Yeah.
Uli kucho kaniambia ukua hapa.
Yeah, kuna hiyo nini. Oh, alafu during summer, like everything is cold. Like they serve everything is cold. Unajua, like it's
yeah.
Kila kitu ni cold. But still, ikikam to hizi stories zote, yeah, na? Ukikuwa kwa hizi societies, like one of the things about sisi, even if when we are not happy with something, we keep it to ourselves. Acheki. So I think ile mom, au ma Americans wanasema wana feel, wana lose US, they are losing it because they are immigrants who go there and start telling them what you're doing is wrong ama what you are whatever. Even that's why unapataka kuna black Americans wakame jam na Africans. Usikuna Africans wendaga huko, wanaanza kuwa judge. Muse maga sita kujudge. Wewe fanya kilo unafanya. Yo ni maisha yako, yo ni maisha yangu. So, I think it would try kusema in very many words. Ni ukienda kwa wenyewe, jo buda, jo tulia, jo. Kipata mtu yana kunia kwa kona. As long as yo mavi itapanguzwa.
Cheza chini.
Wee, cheza chini.
Cheza chini.
Lakini sisi nataka kuenda hapo, unaingia kwa wenyewe. Kula, buda, jo, kuna vile hii TV, jo, hata si straight. Sini weke hivi. Maybe hira yena penaga kuyaga.
Maybe it's crooked.
So I think those are the immigrants.
Yeah.
Wala wanafaa kufight. And this is the reason why ni kuna sema mostly, ikikam to African immigrants. Like kuna time Trump alibonga jua immigrants wa kutoka Congo. Congo ni wase niko shua kienda US wanatulia mbaya. The same way niko shua Kenyans si wenda tunatulia, whatever. But sasa kuna watu utaka kuenda hizi societies alafu wa try kuzi change. You are like, our way is better than your way.
Your way, yeah.
Acheki. And I'll I feel like work. That's where the mistake comes in. Hata hii story yati kienda huko, muna create your own like religious whatever, like institutions. You're making the communities uncomfortable. Don't do it. If they don't want it, they don't want it. You can't say that God is everywhere and then insist on. Unaelewa?
Yeah.
So the same way, mimi kienda India, nachapa a whole month bila nyama, clean.
They don't eat meat.
Stay at all. Stay miss nyama, nikienda India.
Akulangi nyama at all?
I think they are those ones who eat, the ones who are not nini. But you see, the probability if an Indian sees another Indian eating beef, the probability they won't take it as offensive as when they see me as a foreigner eating. You have to understand, if you are the outsider, you stand out. Acheki, nitakuwa hapo jo nimeshikilia jo thaa ya ngombe, wako wewe umekuja ku disrespect Krishna jo. Acha za ovyo. Acheki jo. Shitukia jo, kumbe Krishna ni hoofs za miguu jo. Huko anajua jo. So, to go back to Kenyan politics kidogo, eh? So inasemekana Rigathi's fate is sealed. So kuna watu wana suggest that itakuwa a female deputy president. So what's the probability of that happening? Kenya getting its first female deputy president.
Who? Can you put a name?
Waiguru.
How come every time there's like a huge job anywhere, people tout Waiguru for the job? Like kuna skinga this place that you could take anani Waiguru. Council of Governors take anani Waiguru. What's the Waiguru thing?
I think
position.
Getting away na ile gunia yote ya pesa. You have to respect that. Tuzam to my China jo. Chukua ile gunia ya pesa.
Ita feel ni kama come out of the blue. She's never been a UDA outsider, insider for what I can see. I've never known her to be Ruto's nini.
Hey, kusada Ruto. Try Ruto alikuwa anamtandika.
Mbaya.
Ruto na Murkomen walikuwa wanatandika at some point
na Faruk.
Mm. Kuna time walikuwa wamekatika na yeye sana, but sama wakakuja kakuwa wandani wa Ruto and the rest.
Yeah. Even Rao, there's a time Rao just, you know, every day kwa NYS scandal. But I think nika dem kenye you make moves zake si publicly. She's not, first of all, she's not even I wouldn't say she's a politician sana. I think you ingia hapo for business reasons. I wouldn't say ati, I cannot quote anything ashaisema. I don't know her track record. I don't know.
Ukienda like 8 years ago on YouTube, baki mendika Ruto, Waiguru, NYS. 7 years ago, Ruto slams Waiguru again over NYS scandal. I think the same day, Citizen will comment, give us a break, Ruto tells Waiguru over NYS theft. Then 8 years ago, Waiguru drags DP Ruto's name into NYS scam. And the same year pia ni Waiguru blames NYS scandal on Ruto aid and allies. So check it. So
Ruto aid Faruk.
Yes, yes. So kulikuwa na hiyo toli like then Ruto tells Waiguru to accept responsibility for NYS scandal. Let's check it. So hii kwa hiyo time, but right now then he's my best mbaya. So is it
because she knows how to get things done.
She does?
Ah, she survived.
Yes,
she survived. Like ali chapa nani for governor. Anaitwa nani? Anaitwa the infamous
Kiraitu, is it?
No.
Who was he?
She was running against Martha Karua. Nakumbuka ilikuwa heavily contested. Na check. Nakumbuka Uhuru. Nakumbuka Uhuru vile alimtoa kwa podium.
Minji.
Sia ndio ali make the term Minji kwa nini?
Oh, ilikuwa hiyo
yeye. Ile Kirinyaga ilikuwa Kirinyaga. So they were battling and out na nani na Martha Karua. Oh. And of course ukiangalia track record ya Martha Karua, she offered Uhuru because nakumbuka wakiwa campaign huko it was either Martha or nani. Nakumbuka wote walikuwa kwa podium. Alafu kaka kwa Iguru kwa kaleto. Sida kani kwa mnataka. Oh. So watu wakasema, amechagua Minji.
Oh.
Yani kamtu kayanga tichukarembo. So that's where.
Wacha niwapeleke back
to your time. She just knows how to position herself every time.
I hope this is the right clip, eh? Wacha tucheki.
Kingereza mingi, mwanazifanyia catwalk hapa around. Na ni wazi pesa ya umma imepotea. Mwenye hiyo pesa, anasema aliweka kwa gunia. Sasa jameni kweli dunia hii. You know, we must be honest with ourselves.
Ateki. So hii time alikuwa na bonga juu ya
Catwalk Queen, eh?
Yeah, Catwalk Queen. Alikuwa na bonga specifically juu ya nani?
Waiguru.
Waiguru, yeah. Mm. Yeah. So I think to have come from that to right now, yeah, kuwa nominated, it just shows you, trying to expect a nominate here. It just shows you how Kenyan politics inakuwaga dirty. Like these people just know they are dirty. And inakuwaga like it's your turn to eat, but at some point we'll eat together.
Have you ever read that book, It's Our Turn to Eat?
Michela Wrong. Vishti yetu robu waga mention kwa nini. Kwa page fulani.
Kwa hiyo book, eh?
Ana riding inayo.
Wanasema nga nini?
Ado kimkolo. Michela Wrong. Mimi niko. Bet sijui gani. Kukaba ibo.
Sijua gija.
Yeah.
Kitabu kali sana. People reference your name ya Our Turn to Eat. Udem anai bring vipoa, yani in context kwa your book. Unaelewa why it's called hivyo, why that phrase is so nini. Naweza kupatia your book by the way, unaweza ipitia, ni book interesting sana, but a lot of those things ni tuko far removed from nini. Ni politics ya early to mid 2000s after Rainbow iliwin gava ya Obako. Apparently Obako alikuwa na stroke and you'd never quite recover from a stroke.
Yeah.
You never make
your speech. Speech yake
ile. Yeah, you.
Yeah, alafu.
You never make like a full recovery. Now if uko impaired na any orezo, guys start making calls on your behalf. So dem kuna venye ame bring out kwa book. Hey, watu pao ina corrupt mbaya. Na kuna boy hapo anaitwa John Githongo. You guys simla John Githongo?
Whistleblower.
Yes.
Wa Githongo.
Yes, Githongo.
Githongo kwanza alikuwa anafaa kuja iko nini? I need to follow up on that. Kwa time kwa nafaa kuja akaniambia iko majuu nika think nikasahau.
Akikam naweza taka tu kwa like a fly on the wall, nimuulize tu maswali. Unsee, aya kona like ni msee interesting. So hiyo time ya Obako, he was appointed the anti-corruption czar. Yeah. They call it a czar.
Mm.
Sendal so in charge
ethics and something.
Yes, Sendal in charge of kuni hizo vitu.
Mm.
So vile anatrack kuandika ma report ku follow all the bureaucracies I work. Mm. Akaipeleka old school movie style kiasi akaanza kujipin ma recorder.
Mm.
Anaenda nazo huko ministry. Eh, hey, yani hiyo book ni funny.
Mm.
Mm.
Hey, ilifikia level I think kuna time tulianza ku joke that after Githongo, kuna bidi jo mkiingia cabinet meetings mnaingia mkiwa 3. Naingia mkiwa ndethe. Kwa hiyo ni nini? Asa ni hii ni baraka.
Asa kuna
hey, kato hii ni baraka. Hamuna recorder ndani.
Kuna dea menda kuona, I think sijini minister of finance. Hameva yu recorder. Iko tuko yu book. So yu recorder, akai set the wrong way. Ikaanza kucheza playback.
Mm.
So unaongea na hivi unamrecord, but ikaanza kucheza playback, ikaanza kumekio noise.
Mm.
Immediately akaanza tuku cough uncontrollably, akaenda washroom. Na yonde ilimsave, wakujua alikuwa na record.
Oh.
But he was recording them. Now they were this close to knowing kwa sababu ilianza kucheza hizo recordings in their faces.
Oh shit, that's a movie shit.
It's it is some crazy shit ukiisoma. Akaanza kukof tu, akaenda kwa washroom, akairia just akarudi. Sa hiyo ako nervous and a break my sweat.
Yeah, hiyo ni za jishondea.
Asa anamwambia relax. Wana pigo kwa madeal zingine.
Hiyo ni za jishondea, kwa kama vile tuko na ubuda anaitwa, anaitwa nani ule? Watenge. Tenge jo alikuwa nasema jo Biwot alitandika ganani risasi jo. Alipiga
huko. Huko.
Like pa ye mwenyewe.
State house.
Alipiga risasi. So, wajua, those are the sort of people you deal with. Unachikini hata kuna time nikiadvisigi, nikibonga gajua, naitua nani, Morara mubonga gajua that level of politics. Wasona fikina mdiscourage. Musema ga, in life lazima ujua who you are dealing with. Lazima ujua wasona deal nao, si wasa wa kawaida. Kuna sisi, wasewa, tutuongea mbaya online. Retweet. Alafu kuna wasa watakuliza buda ni aje. Umedai aje. Miss kitu sikuachi. Alafu wakutandike nini. So kuna hiyo whatever. Of course sasa focus. We unaonaje nini? We ni Gen Z ama si Gen Z?
Mi ni millennial.
We ni millennial.
Mm, okay. 94.
Okay. Mm. 2020 whatever unaonaje lakini?
27.
Wasa natoke ama watoke?
Iyo by the itakwa. It's a very, like every other, like every time a president tries to win the election in this country, 2027 will be no different. Mm. It will be tough for him. Kwa sababu this whole Ruto must go thing, bro.
Meshika.
Bro.
Nichekita majuzi, ilikuwa when, saizi tuko, ilikuwa on Sato. I think nicheki, ata nasikia kwa Blankets and Wine, ilikuwa. Na niya kiperform jo, mbaka alikuwa na shindwa ni aje. Waka mseka South Africa, Nasty C. Kalikuwa like, who's Ruto? I don't know how true that is. But apart from that, pia nilichiki images. These are one of these Ibizas. Waswali stop ngoma. Wakaanza kuchant, Ruto must go.
But it's one thing for guys to just chant it and sing it. And another thing kufanya like, walk the talk. Organize, wasewa vote.
Sindo na national kiuliza juya turnout. Because if the turnout is crazy, it's because people want him gone. If the turnout is kawaida, it's because watu wataki want him gone. But I feel like he's the one person ulimeonyesha say that voting is important. He did not do it intentionally, but I feel like he showed people that voting is important. And that's why I feel like personally, everyone I've talked to anasema, turnout itakuwa crazy. So, wana ichekiaje?
Itakuwa hivyo, I think itakuwa crazy. But guys also need to like, who will they vote for? Who you vote for is another very important thing.
Mi nasema angajua taikuwe dogi jo, fadhali umboja. Choka jo.
Hautapoteza kura hiyo design.
Using a scandal, I feel like using a scandal, there are too many. Saizi tunapatia na airport, tunapatia ase, watakamkawa na tudharau, watakuwa like, cheki. So, yeah, I don't know what to think about that. Yeah. And nini, pia, tuki stick na politics kidogo, nani mnamuonaje jo? Itumbi finally got a job. And job yake ni special programs and creative economy. So, yeah, ni the office of special programs and creative.
He's never had a job. Siena ngapo like.
Zia alikuwa gamtuwa enda hapa, rudi hapa. Sikuizi yu postuma picha zake kwa ofisi ya kisikiza hasi. Akisema vile wanatushugulikia.
Ebu soma yu post, ati yu post ni?
Ye waka kwa the office of special programs and creative economy. So creative economy ni vitu kama podcasts pia. So he's the head of presidential special projects and creative economy.
Do you know this guy? Unajua Itumbi? Do you like
Azizi? Same job.
But you gonna like, you gonna very like ask kama if that's his title, alafu kwa anawakanaseka nyinyi. He should be like, ama I'm thinking wrong, because abu like, you look at the guys who are in the like podcast landscapes, you any creative economy, una reach out, unaangalia vile wanazidu, venye wanazidiscuss, if you really want to make an impact kwa ground. Otherwise, it's just like a title.
Okay,
cool. Mimi naona ni ni prize yake ya loyalty.
Yeah, he's very loyal. Just
there to look for something. Of course, they had tried the CAS routes, of course, Gen Z, after financial, whatever, it was something, zenye pia, Ruto, he had to restructure and, you know, cut them out. Walikuwa wanasema they don't want that nini. And then before dissolvata cabinet yake whatever, so he was supposed to get a CAS position. Of course he ikakuwa dismissed sahi because of he's everywhere na check. He's everywhere hata kwa mikono ya Rigathi being manhandled. So so I think he deserves it according to Ruto.
Yeah.
Because you only like nimekupatia. It's a position I've never even had. Like
it's just, man, they've created
special programs.
Yes, special programs.
Presidential special programs. Maybe Nizila's like you're going to identify the most outstanding Kenyans. Vitu zingine zile idea pia nani alikuanga nazo.
Ababu. Chekijua Ababu majuzi, sijua ameenda ametravel ameenda majuu. Yuko huko. Kuzo seka Ababu ni wasi wako lucky sana. Kuzo njua, he did not get a job he deserved. Which vote did Ababu add? Ajani ndio watu nilisikia mkikosea Rigathi ya shiva. Lakini Ababu alirata kura. Ababu alirata kura gani?
I think, na kuna mse alituambia hivi, it's either you're bringing numbers
or you're bringing or money. So do you think Ababu brought anything? He does not have the money to bring.
Money or something.
Ababu?
Money? Ababu?
There was a time
this Limani and maybe a service that it Ababu's, was in ile like
Ababu started Juana. In ODM.
Yeah.
You remember his ODM
days? An MP for Bundalangi.
And Bundalangi or something. Aliko so like he was one of those like he
vibrant.
Was
radicals.
Yes.
Wa baba.
Yes, he was like, so opinionated, vociferous na opinions zake nini. So I think apparently
ange maintain ODM it'd be bigger. You know that? Yes, he ended up being as yes, but it was very small.
Here's the thing. There's being big and then there's getting into government na easy for what they do, like amassing wealth, getting a lot of money. I feel like ODM inakupanga platform unakuwa very, you can be big, people utakuwa na very credibility in a lot of what you say. But at the end of the day, asana ndanga huma na unaswa gavama zivilona.
Una kula.
Una get. So, you know, so nilikuwa sema, I read somewhere, Ruto, like, he has, like, a very interesting method when you anafostanga his relationships. So, anangalianga mse, anam criticize. Alafu, anam criticize, like, dead on. Yani mse, like, his friendship with David Ndii. Apparently, he said, when he started messing up, when the government, yake na unyili anza kufenye, make some mistakes, the first guy to point it out perfectly in an article was Ndii.
Oh.
Yeah, so, akianza kupull together team yake 2022, the first person he reached out to was him.
Oh, okay.
Similar to nani Ababu. Ababu is a lawyer, I think. No. There was a time alikuwa anamcriticize. I think when he was back DP. So alikuwa anasoma hizo ni zake, I don't know. Ubwa anamcriticize, but anamcriticize yani vitu. It's dead on.
Okay.
So eventually I think aka make meeting na aka explain standpoint yake nini wakafosta ka friendship kutoka hapo. So I think maybe ni friendships tu anagetingi za wase, anajua hata kama mse hata nipea kura, I know how they'll be valuable to me. Amekuwa kiwa cheki.
Okay, it makes sense. It makes sense. Alafu tukimalizia, tutamalizia na hii story. Corruption costs Uganda 322 billion Kenyan shillings a year. Not Uganda. 322 billion Kenyan shillings a year.
UG.
Yes, corruption. Kenyan shillings.
What's going to happen?
What does that mean? Because I feel like for such a poor country, at some point, the country has to come first.
Yeah. I think hiyo ndio ilikuwa gana the kingdom, whatever system.
These sections, yes, like in Baganda.
I don't think they've they ever evolved fully from that.
But you know, nani, how some Ghanaians is Rwandese.
Nani?
Hata hizo jina zake, Kagame. Kagame, Kaguta.
Koguta. But I think the... there's some... kuna level fulani.
Museveni.
Yeah, Museveni is Rwandese.
Tinye nasema hivyo.
Hata Museveni alisaidiwa kuwa president na nani?
Yeah, he fought in his army.
Yeah. Na Kagame alisaidia Kaguta. Na Kaguta pia nisaweka alisaidia Kagame.
Yeah.
They're both
army. Kuna both time, kuna time wanaleta nanga juu. Because watu wezi toka, hakuna nani... kuna time Rwanda angepitia UG. Majuzi, like 5 years ago, angepitia UG wakienda Rwanda. So I don't know walikuwa napitia njia gani. But there's a level, nyonasema hivyo, because there's a level as, you know, as much as Kenya ni tunachoma, kuna leaders.
UG
kuna leaders wenye, kama Githongo, you know, if kama ingekuwa Uganda, tungejua Githongo.
Yeah.
Tungejua the fact that alienda na ka-expose wa say na sahi, he's somewhere, you know. Hakunge kuwa na buku kama peeling off the mask.
Kume umapamba mapema.
Hata umadamu wa nini. It's my turn to it. Hange kuwa. So, and there are a lot of even, kuna ma-politicians wengi wenye uu iso blow. Na siyati wanapewa anything. Na check, ni ile, kuna ile level wenye unaona, ah, this is too much. Iyo haiko. We've seen it in UG and TZ. Yeah, mina zasema tu yoni nature yao, they are okay. We've even had someone hapa akisema, uko, we don't talk too much. I think uko scared. Uko traumatized.
Yeah, yeah.
We don't talk too much. If it works, ni sawa. So long as we have food.
Yes, sebo. Sebo.
So, uko like, dude, I don't know kama mko na 5G internet, kama 4G. I don't know the fuck you
use. End of the crazy thing about getting into to government through the gun. Umsema zea mehold your country. Ni kama mehold two hostage yani. Yeah, everything tu ni.
I don't know. Ila time nimeuliza kitu ingine. Ati does the country ever come first? Nikabaki nime realize. African countries zinafaa ku identify as men so they come first. Because they identify as women. They never come. Notice. Na wonga like Kenya. Countries waga madame.
Her future.
Yeah, Kenya chukua she. Like
her prosperity.
And feminine. It never comes first. She notice. Like it's always the politicians. Yeah. Wana screw tu na. Wana milk na. But ni sad sana la place ka UG. Because can't try imagine how much you do with 322 million shillings in UG in a year. That
billion.
Would, yes, billion. That would assure you of a life presidency. You'd never, ata, akina nani wanaitwa watu wanakufight akina Bobby Wine, they'd have nothing to talk about. So kuna shida so ujiletea najibu, you can solve this like hata Ruto bila try to change constitution na go president forever. If he was doing his work hata inza fika level tumesahau tuko like umetuachia wewe kuwa tu president. You know, place kama inakuwa Germany, no one cares chancellor ni nani. So kuna kuwa gana hizo. But Buddha so mesema, watu wanza kupata Fridays.
Shukran maze. Fridays, so starting this Friday, 11th October, there's an open mic stand-up comedy in Tao. Come through, it's free, but sijui neza show poster, come neza kapo. There's a booking number on the poster.
Yeah.
Book a spot, come let's laugh. Maze mi, tumonge a lot of politics, but maze mimi, I am a comic. Through and through mini comedian too maze. And I love the comedy. Tuataka sasa support hii sini yetu. Come through maze. Hata Rapture nimeniliona. I think he has a special APN. Comedy community maze. Maze.
So hiyo ya Rapture pia wacha ni remind wa say December 21st. Wapi? Nairobi Cinema. Tickets ni 1500 shillings.
Yeah.
Zina go on sale this week. So kuwa rada.
Ni Christmas Street.
Ni Christmas Street. Tubaki tumecheck ni aje jo. So mtaimia tu ya kuhepa. Kama kawaida vile susemaga like, subscribe. Hit the notification button. Tell a friend. Tukimalizia tukisema Eko Nene.
Eko Nene.